about dun sa video na very controversial na nauna nang nagsalita ang Secretary Gibo, Secretary Abalos, pero gusto ko rin din basahin ng pahayag naman ni dating Pangulong Rodrigo Duterte regarding dun sa issue na ito. I'd like to read the statement of our former president. Sabi dito, BBM's refusal is the best authentication. The hakbang ng maisog national leadership has nothing to do with the release of the video footage showing President Marcos Jr. or President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in the act of snorting cocaine in maisog gatherings in Vancouver, Canada and Los Angeles, USA. It was a decision made entirely by the Maisog volunteers to places without the knowledge and imprimatur of the Maisog Organizing Committee. The members of the Maisog leadership is just as surprised as the rest of the country when they saw it for the first time. Attempt to destabilize the administration of President Marcos. First, the Marcos administration's feeble attempt to dismiss the video by simple denial actually reinforces the simmering suspicion of President Marcos's drug addiction. As any lawyer knows, denial is the weakest form of defense. It has to do better than that. Even the ordinary man on the street knows that the best way to put the issue is to or to rest is for President Marcos to undergo a hair follicle drug test. When undertaken by a credible drug testing center, a negative result would erase all doubts once and for all. Instead of doing that, however, President Marcos responded either with feigned laughter, feeble denial, or complete silence. A drug user for a president is no laughing matter. And he should be the first one to know that. In a critical juncture in the nation's history, when he has threatened to send the country's soldiers to war, the president's drug habit poses a clear and present danger. With due apologies to all the experts who vouch for the authenticity of the video, the refusal of President Marcos to undergo the hair follicle drug test is the best proof not only of the video's authenticity, but worse, his drug addiction. The denial issued by the Department of National Defense is a slap in the face of every patriotic and honorable soldier who lives by the military's highest code of conduct. It is bad enough that the DND has to do the country the dirty job of issuing the denial. It is worse than in doing so, it has become a party to a despicable act it should have been fighting against in the first place. It is strange that instead of confronting the president about it, the mainstream media, who once proudly boasted as the freest press in Asia, has chosen to look the other way. If subsequent events prove that his drug habits are indeed true, they will forever be haunted by the memory of having contributed to the massive cover-up of his criminal activities. The shameless act of legislators from both Senate and Congress to stand with President Marcos at this time of moral and legal crisis will forever be remembered by our people. They had this chance to be on the right side of history, but they just wasted this chance. By this act of showing in public what had long been whispered in private, the men and women of Maisog have proven themselves worthy to be called Filipinos. They have exposed themselves to danger and harm, but they are ready to make the sacrifices to rid this country of a head of state that is an embarrassment all over the world. They now proudly take their place in the annals of Philippine history for standing up when the rest cowered in fear. The next few days will be very crucial to every Filipino and the Filipino nation. It will require every citizen to decide whether to be part of those who seek the truth and those who are involved in the cover-up. It is a choice between standing up and demanding that this country enforce the law without fear or favor, or hiding in fear and self-preservation. It will not be an easy choice. Either way, it will define us individually and as a people. Staying neutral is actually a vote of confidence for an administration that shows no compunction. Whatever that decision remained with us. Abraham Lincoln once said, "The fiery trial through which we must pass will light us down in honor or dishonor to the latest generation." Indeed, we are passing through a fiery trial, and history will ultimately judge us whether we did so in honor or dishonor. By President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. And with a statement of our former president, I would like to get yung comment po ng ating panel. Gusto ko po unahin sa Sir Jason, sa
mo yung pinagtataka ko lang eh. Kasi di kung tutusin, yung expose doon sa drugs, no? Doon sa allegation na nagaano siya, actually hindi allegation eh, kundi yun ang pinapakita, no? Na sumisingot siya ng cocaine. Eh, is personal to Mr. Marcos. I am surprised na ang nagsasalita, si Abalos, si Gibo, kung sino-sino pa, na ang dapat nagsasalita nito, kung talagang lalaki siya, no? Kung may bayag siya, sabi nga sa usapan Tagalog, no? Oh. Eh, anong tawag nito? Sagutin niya. Oh, kung hindi siya addict, sabihin niya, oh, hindi siya addict. Kung addict siya, aminin niya. Oh, paggamot siya. Useless naman, mauupo pa siya. Napakawalang yamo naman, addict ka na tapos uupo ka rin presidente. Oh. Hindi na siguro tama 'yun. Oh.